We think Azure SQL Database is the best database for developers. Join this video to see why on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman. Welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Davide Mauri, who's a program manager on the SQL DB team. Thanks for joining us today.
Hey, Hannah. Thank you for inviting me.
Always a pleasure. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do on the team before we get started?
Yeah, sure. So as you said, I'm a PM on the Azure SQL team. And what I do is take care of developer relationships. So I try to work a lot with developers. And also I take care of hyperscale specifically, trying to make sure that he is the best database for developers to be.
Awesome. And so, you know, kind of what you said there is a great lead in. I think you're actually going to tell us today, you know, why is Azure SQL Database the best database for developers?
Yeah, correct. And it just happens that I also have a slide deck prepared, you know. So let me share with you. And Hugo, so I just want to discuss with you today some of the features that I think make Azure SQL probably the best database, at least for me, for developers. So first of all, let's start discussing why customers choose Azure SQL. Mainly because it's a great general purpose button included post-relational database. So it's kind of a mouthful, but it really convey the value of the product. A general purpose because you can do basically everything with it. Better included because, as you will see in a minute, has a lot of features that are already included in the product and that you don't have to go and find somewhere else and then try to figure out how to integrate those features with Azure SQL. And post-relational because like years and years have passed from its relational inception. It's still relational in the core, but it evolved towards kind of a supporting different models. So it's really a mature post-relational database. It has security built in, so it really gives all the option to users and developers and sysadministrator to basically secure everything from columns, table, rows even, and organize people in group, make sure application can only access data, encrypt data at rest and in flight. So it really provides a completely and secure environment for developer to work. It's support scale out. This is something that not a lot of developers knows. Historically, relational databases weren't that good at scaling out. But with Azure SQL and Hyperscale specifically, we redesigned the engine to be a kind of microservices architecture so that we can easily scale out and support really a huge amount of concurrent queries and connection. It has advanced analytical processing. So today, HTAP is all the rage. And we've been doing HTAP in the past was called real-time analytics or near real-time analytics since 2008. So we have kind of a good historical track of having both row store and column store together. And I think we should discuss this in a dedicated video because it's pretty interesting. We have also a lot of high-concurrency optimization done over the years. So another thing that not many developers knows is that there are ways for Azure SQL not to use locks to preserve data consistency. So you can choose, it's one of the few databases, I would say, where you can choose if you want to use locks or not to keep data consistent, which give developers a great flexibility because they can exactly choose what is the best model for them. It provides a great development experience in the sense that once upon a time, it was called a transparent database. Transparency in the sense that it shows everything you need to know in order to understand what's going on, how performance are doing through the time, and if not, is working as you expect, to exactly understand why is not working as you expect. So you have, today people call it a DAG, directed acyclic graph. Basically, we've been having that feature, again, since when Azure SQL was born, and we just call it execution plan. So you can see exactly all the steps that will be done by the relational engine to execute your query. And this helps you a lot to understand where things are slower than you expect and where you have to work to improve your performance. Then you also have geospatial support. So within the engine, there is a complete geospatial engine that allows you to take two points on Earth and then understand how far they are from each other, if they intersect, what is the shortest distance between them. So it really adds the ability to integrate geospatial information within your application without having to go again and somewhere else and look for something that then you have to integrate manually. And then we also just, this is kind of recent, introduced multimodal capabilities, because not only we support relational features, of course, but we also support JSON, we support graph structures, and also we support key value store using something called in-memory table or a hackathon, as someone knows this feature by this name. So it's really, as you can see, it's really comprehensive. It has everything inside the database, and what I really love of this is that everything fits together with each other features. So you can use, for example, in-memory table with column store, or use graph models with column store, or you can do scale out with geospatial. So you can really pick and choose and create the perfect solution for you. And I think this is really, really unique in the market.
Yeah, I mean, it certainly seems like there's a lot of capabilities here, and probably explains, you know, why we have, I think, over 6 million databases running in Azure right. SQL or something like that.
Yeah,
it's a lot. Now, you know, when we talk about like some of the specific things customers are doing or what we're seeing, are we seeing only enterprises move towards something like Azure SQL? Or can you expand a little bit on that?
No, right, absolutely. So one of the beautiful things that are happening, and again, not many knows, is that a lot of startups are using Azure SQL to basically be the support for their growth. So one that we just published a case study is Big Red Cloud. It's an Irish company that started cloud native to provide accounting solution to the customer, and they rely on Azure SQL and specifically Hyperscale here, because Hyperscale gives them the ability to grow up to 100 terabytes without changing code. Hyperscale will take care of, you know, everything is needed to grow and take care of such amount of data, but for them it's completely transparent, and there is basically no limits. When you say you can grow up to 100 terabytes today, this means no limits. And actually, the 100 terabyte limit is an artificial limit we put today, just to put a limit, because actually we can grow much more than that. Yeah, at some point you need to put a limit just to make sure that you don't have any issues with something you haven't tested yet. But we tested everything until 100 terabytes, everything scaled amazingly. And this gives the peace of mind to customers that they can start to work on a database, start very small, like, you know, several megabytes maybe, but then grow as much as they can or as much as they want without having to move to another system, migrate, and, you know, all those things that were really, really painful in the past and still are, honestly. So this is an example. But of course, as you said, we also cover the complete opposite part of the spectrum. So we go from startup to really huge enterprise like Bing Ads. So Bing Ads is basically the enterprise solution that powers Microsoft advertising. And as you can see, we have a huge amount of data hosted there. And in fact, they had to create a sharding solution on Azure SQL. So they even went to completely extreme, because 100 terabytes were not even enough for them. So they went and created a sharding solution using some well-known techniques that are also available in our architecture guides to make sure that they can scale out as much as they want and, you know, support all the possible ads and platforms that we want to host in Bing Ads. So that's another amazing story that we published as a detailed blog post on also the technical choices that has been made to make sure that Bing Ads can exist and grow as they need.
That's awesome. And I mean, it seems like we kind of covered the gamut, right? We started with some startups, then you told us about, you know, obviously a huge company or part of our company that everyone's heard of, Bing Ads. And you also talked about how this relates to developers. I think, you know, we had so much we wanted to talk about that we're actually going to do a second part of this after this, right?
Yeah, that makes sense, because there is really a lot of, you know, to discuss, and just to give you some ideas what I would like to discuss with you in future, is some of the features and architecture and pattern that we saw people using and using successfully on Azure SQL. So web applications are all about event sourcing, CQRS, sharding, as we discussed before, caching. So all these new modern kind of patterns or architecture are now becoming, I would say, daily used. And Azure SQL is actually a very good place where to implement those patterns, because it really provides support for everything. So for example, if you are using Go or you're using Ruby or of course .NET or Python, you have driver that allows you to connect to Azure SQL. You have ORMs or micro ORMs that help you to kind of minimize the amount of code you have to write. Beside libraries, we also have native support to some cool feature like change tracking. You just discussed this in the build demo, and it's amazing because it allows developers to basically transfer in a very efficient way data between their mobile application and Azure SQL, almost without writing code. You just really have to write a couple of lines of code. And when I had to do it back in the days to implement a correct change tracking manually, it's really, really a kind of an effort, and now having it for free in Azure SQL is like, wow, it's amazing.
Just one of the many reasons that Azure SQL database is the best database for developers.
Yeah, absolutely. And then, as you can see, there are many other memory optimized table, as I discussed before, that allows us to scale as much as we can because they don't use locking. JSON support, it's kind of vital for developers. And of course, something also a developer doesn't think enough is GODR. So this a disaster recovery, it's important. We support the GODR, so you can create a copy of Azure SQL in another region, and we will take care for you of switching and falling back to another region if that is needed. And we just recently introduced a kind of a good experience, I would say, also for DevOps. This is also another thing you just showed in the build demo, and I think it's amazing. Now we can put Azure SQL as part of our DevOps pipeline, which help developer to have a consistent CI/CD experience, make sure that when you deploy something, you can be almost sure, I would say, that everything will go as planned. And that's great, because that's a huge challenge, especially with databases and data. It's a little bit more complex than with the application. So yeah, definitely we should talk about this stuff, absolutely.
Awesome. Well, thanks for joining us today. And if you like this video, be sure to like this video and tune in for the next video, where we're going to dive into a little bit more details around the architectures. Thanks for joining us on Data Exposed.
Thank you.